Hey guys, what's going on? Jeff here from Films at Home. And in today's video, I want to talk about ripping your Blu-ray collection to a hard drive on your computer and whether that is really worth the time and effort. Hey guys, so thanks for coming back to the channel. Now, if you've been following me on Instagram at all the last few weeks, you've noticed that I've been trying to do a quick little media transfer where I took some movies from my collection, Blu-rays and 4K, and moved them over to a hard drive on my computer, and then wanted to use the Plex Media Server app to stream those movies throughout my house in pretty decent quality and also share it with family and friends. Now I'm gonna talk about my experiences with that in this video, what kind of worked for me, what didn't work, whether I think it's worth the time and effort. Lots of stuff in here because I know there's a lot of questions. I'm a physical media guy first and foremost, but there is something to be said for having digital backups, convenience, and other things. So we'll address all that in this video. Now, if you like this sort of thing, home theater, Blu-ray, 4K collecting, physical media, reviews, things like that, please consider subscribing to the channel. Like this video if you enjoy what I have to say, and also leave me a comment. I want to know what your guys' thoughts are on Plex and ripping Blu-rays, because I think it's a very interesting topic that I hadn't really dove into before, but I am now that I've tried it myself, so I want to hear your thoughts on it. So just last week, I started with couple programs on my computer, and this is basically how you get started with ripping Blu-rays. You're gonna need a hard drive, and a very big hard drive. Now a typical Blu-ray disc, say Office Space here, pretty typical, doesn't have a lot of crazy, you know, audio tracks on it or anything. It's probably gonna run between 30 to 40 gigabytes, and then, you know, upwards of 40 to 45 gigabytes is on the kind of high end of a Blu-ray, and then 4K discs can run up to 100 gigabytes. So if you think about storage capacity, that's the first thing you need to think about. And, you know, 1 terabyte is 1,000 gigabytes. And so if one of these movies, let's just say it's an even 50, you can get 20 movies on to 1 terabyte, right? At 50 gigabytes a pop, only 20 movies on 1 terabyte. And so you really need to think about massive amounts of storage if you want to do a straight one-to-one conversion of your Blu-rays. Now, what I was doing was I was backing these up and ripping them to my computer with a Blu-ray drive. And I was using a program called MakeMKV. That does give you an exact one-to-one copy. What I did after I got the one-to-one copy was that I put it into a program called Handbrake, which compresses it, and you can pick and choose kind of which audio you want to pass over. And I was able to get, you know, a 35 or 40 gigabyte file down to just 4 or 5 gigabytes with pretty good quality. And so if you think about that, now if it's 5 gigabytes per disc, you can fit 200 Blu-ray discs on a 1 terabyte drive, and then multiply that by however many you had. I ended up buying a 5 terabyte drive, and so my goal was to put 1,000 movies, 200 by every terabyte, 200 times 5 is 1,000. I wanted to get 1,000 Blu-ray discs onto that hard drive, and I also had another 3 terabytes of storage that I had bought separately, and so I could have gone as high as 1,600 Blu-ray discs. And so that's really what you have to think about first is storage. 5 terabyte drive cost me about $100. You can get a 1 or 2 terabyte drive for 50. You can go upwards of an 8 terabyte, 10 terabyte. And you can also get multiple drives and connect them all to the same source or the same server. And so I know lots of people that have 50, 60 terabytes of storage that I talked to during this process. And that's what you basically need to figure out. Do you want to do a one-to-one copy, or do you want to compress things? One-to-one copies are going to require a ton of space and storage. In compressing them, you will lose a little bit of quality. You may lose an HD audio track, but you're going to be able to fit many more discs and many more digital backups onto your server. So that was kind of the first thing I did. I took a bunch of discs I wanted to back up, and I burnt them to my computer using MakeMKV. I compressed them with Handbrake, and then I kind of looked and said, okay, I've got 15 or 20 movies that I ripped. Now what I did was I got Plex Media Server, which is an application that basically allows you to start your own home media server, and then you can share that server with friends so they can stream things from your network to theirs. Essentially, think of it like creating your own Netflix. And so I could take Office Space, load it from the ripped copy on my computer, load that onto a hard drive, tell Plex which hard drives to pick from, and then Plex will look into those folders, find all the movies, and it does a good job. It gives you lots of helpful information. It pulls in the movie poster, the cast list, what kind of audio is available for you, how you can stream it, what kind of quality, a synopsis of the film. It has a ton of information, and it pulls that all in from its online servers. All you need to do is provide it a file and give it the year. So I would say Office Space, what year did this come out? 1999. Office Space in parentheses 1999, Plex would pull everything in. And so I did that with all my movies, and I built up a little Plex server of 15 to 20 movies. That was a great start, and that's where I started my testing, and where, honestly, for me, things started to go downhill. So when I was just viewing the ripped quality backups on my computer, they looked pretty good. 5 gigabytes, you know, I tried it on a TV. I hooked it up to a TV before I had Plex, and I just played back the video, and it looked pretty good. It's not Blu-ray quality. It's not 4K quality, but I'd say you could compare it to like a 1080p stream from Netflix, which is fine for me in other areas of the house where I don't have the home theater. If I wanted to watch a movie, that works for me. Obviously in the home theater, I'm going physical all the way, but this was more convenience. I could watch movies on my phone. I travel for work a lot. I could watch them on my phone, my laptop in hotel rooms. I could watch my whole collection. And a big selling point was being able to share it with family and friends who always want to get their hands on the latest movies. They want to see them, but we don't necessarily live super close together, and I often give away digital codes. And so, you know, I end up giving them a bunch of discs maybe once a month. And so it's not the most convenient thing. This would have been much more convenient for sharing my collection with others. Now, when I started Plex up, I immediately had pretty good success. I tried it internally on my home network, and I streamed things to my living room TV, to my bedroom TV. I streamed stuff to my phone and to my laptop, and everything worked okay. There were some audio sync issues, particularly with Terminator Dark Fate for some reason. I backed that up and it would not sync up right. But I figured it was just a flaw. I went back, re-ripped it, and that solved the issue. The real problems came when I started streaming this outside of my network. And so that's something to consider. Now, if you like to have a home media server and it's only gonna be played within your home on your network, then Plex is probably a pretty good option. But for me, where I wanted to share it, your computer, which mine is pretty powerful, it's a 2017 iMac, it has 16 gigs of RAM, it has an i7 processor, it has a 3 terabyte Fusion drive, so it's got a solid state drive in there as well for the OS. Like, it's a very powerful computer, it's a powerhouse. I use it to video edit and do all sorts of stuff for work. And so it shouldn't have had any issues, and it didn't. It streamed, and I had my family members try it. Problem was, when they were streaming it, it was extremely poor quality. It was pixelating. Things were buffering. Things were freezing in the middle. The audio wasn't great. There were a lot of problems. Now, that probably could have been fixed by me going through Plex settings and really tweaking both on their end and on my end what kind of stream I want to send over to them. But I really wanted to send 1080p at least 8 megabits per second, and I couldn't get it to work. Now, the other thing was, while it was serving as the home server, my internet throughout the house, I have very strong internet. It's 250 megabit upload, 250 download. So I think it's a 250, 250, which is pretty good considering there's only two people in the house, and, you know, I'm not doing a ton of streaming. If we are, it's only on one device. Apparently that wasn't good enough for Plex though, because when I was streaming, my internet quality dropped 20 times lower. I was getting down crazy low speeds. I was trying to download an update for a game on my PlayStation. It was downloading like a snail. My phone was losing Wi-Fi connection and wasn't loading things properly. And overall, I was putting a huge bog on my network. It was bogging it down and just killing my wireless. And so, for the reason that there wasn't great quality on the other end and the fact that it just throttled my home network, Plex really didn't work for me. And so if that's the way you want to go, I wouldn't recommend it unless you have like a super strong gigabit connection. Maybe you're hardwired in right to your router, or you have some sort of dedicated server, but that can cost hundreds, if not thousands of dollars. And I wasn't willing to spend that. I was hoping to use my already very expensive Mac computer, all the money I'd spent on storage and Blu-ray drives, and roll that into a nice home media server. And I couldn't do it. So that was really disappointing. Now, this isn't to say that it's not going to work for everybody. Like I said, if you want a home media server just to play on your internal network, Plex worked really well. But I think their big selling point is that you can kind of share with family and friends outside of your home, and that's not quite there yet, in my opinion. Especially, I have a great internet connection, probably better than 3/4 of the country even has access to, because I'm living near Boston in a big city, and you know, we have good internet here. If you don't have good internet access, Plex is not gonna work for you. It may not even work internally. It is a hog on your network, and it takes a lot of bandwidth. Now, a lot of information there. I sort of gave you my whole story, but the question is ripping your Blu-ray discs to a hard drive worth it? And in my opinion, because of the time it took and the effort, I personally would say no. Now, a lot of people will differ there. But if you look at a typical Blu-ray, again, say Office Space, 40 gig file roughly, that's going to take about an hour to rip on Make MKV. And then it will take another 45 minutes to an hour on Handbrake. And so you need to spend 2 hours of your computer, you know, just being in use doing this, ripping Blu-rays, just to get one copy. And so if you look at a collection like mine, there's 2,500 discs times 2 hours of disc. That doesn't include other time taking the disc out, running back and forth from the computer to the collection. It's 5,000 hours. It's an insane amount of time to back up a collection of this size. Now, if you had a smaller collection, or maybe you wanted to back up a bunch of DVDs, or maybe only your rare or obscure out-of-print movies, that would make sense. But in order to back up a collection of even a few hundred Blu-rays, it's going to take a serious time suck. And for me, it just wasn't worth it when I have the disc, and Blu-ray discs are pretty resilient. I have discs that are 10 years old now that aren't showing any signs of wear, 12 years old. Of course, I have DVDs that are 20 years old. And there's always talk of like disc rot and other manufacturing things that could happen. But we've still got people playing VHS and Laserdisc tapes from the 80s. That was 30 years ago. And so I don't foresee it really being an issue, especially as the media has gotten better, from Blu-ray discs to now 4K Ultra HD Blu-ray discs. The quality keeps getting better. I haven't heard any real serious concerns of disc rot in anybody's collection, where discs are literally rotting inside the cases and you're not able to play them back. That's not a real thing, in my opinion. If it is, it's a manufacturing error on a specific disc. It's not a widespread problem. And so for me, I don't really see a need to back up all of your movies, except for the rare case if you wanted to get rid of a bunch of DVDs, or you had that obscure out-of-print title you wanted to back up. In my eyes, the digital backup, you know, might make sense for somebody with a smaller collection, but I have, you know, think about it this way. If you're using it as a traditional, like as an actual backup to back up your collection, just in case something happened, right? You know, great. There's a fire in your house and you lose your whole collection. Your insurance will cover your collection as long as you have it worked in there, which I would highly recommend if you have a home or an apartment. Put your collection value into your home insurance. I certainly have, because it's a big piece of value in your house. But if you have a traumatic event like that, I think the last thing in your mind is going to be how you backed up all your movies. You know, you potentially have massive damage to your house, and I'm not going to go and build another house just in case this house collapses, because of the amount of time and effort and money that would take. And so I'm kind of viewing the collection in the same way. When you have a collection this large, yeah, I could go build another collection. This collection took me 10 years to build. I could go do that digitally, but really, what time am I saving for a 1 in a million chance? Sure, like, knock on wood that it doesn't happen, but, you know, even in the unfortunate case it does, what are the chances that even, you know, computer or hard drive survives something like that if it's inside your house? So overall, yeah, in my opinion, if your collection's any more than a few hundred Blu-rays, this is a serious time suck. And if you're that committed to physical media, it doesn't make much sense to go and build a home media server. You know, it would make sense if you do have a bunch of digital copies to, you know, give people access to your Movies Anywhere account. But even with the Plex server, you can't put movies from iTunes or Google Play or Movies Anywhere into Plex. There's DRM, there's copywritten stuff, they block it. And so if you already have all those digital backups from the digital codes that came with many of your movies, that's a better bet for you than Plex and trying to rely on your own home server and throttling your home internet to operate that. You're better off letting Movies Anywhere and iTunes handle it on their servers and keep your internet running smoothly. So, you know, overall, it wasn't for me. Maybe it's for you guys. I'd be interested to hear your opinions. I'm certainly not putting it down. I don't want to come off too negative. Like I said, if it was for home internal use, it worked really well. I was just really disappointed in the streaming portion of it and trying to get access to it, you know, on my phone at an airport or in a hotel on my laptop was a huge part of why I was doing it. And it just wasn't working out. So there's really no reason for me to continue and spend literally years backing this collection up. And so for that reason, you know, I didn't go that way. But I'm sure many of you have different thoughts. Maybe you have dedicated servers or, you know, better connections and can pull this off. But honestly, I think for most people, a lot of you out there who are curious, this really probably isn't for you. It's much easier to spend $10 on a Blu-ray disc and buy an extra Blu-ray player for your living room, which is what I've now done. Spend $80 on a Blu-ray player instead of $100 on storage and another $500 on a server and another $100 a month on extra internet connection and better bandwidth and all that stuff. You know, invest in another player. That would be my opinion. And even if you needed three players and you dropped $200, it's gonna be cheaper and a lot less time than trying to back everything up on a Plex server. So thanks for watching, guys. This wasn't a planned video, but as I kind of ran into this, I thought it would be interesting for a lot of you out there who may have been thinking about doing something similar. I know a lot of questions came up when I started mentioning it, so hopefully this was helpful. It's a little bit of a long video. I talked a lot. I'm going to, you know, I try to put in some visuals and stuff to break it up, but it's really just a topic I have to talk a lot about. And so it is what it is. But thanks for watching to the end here. Remember to follow me on Instagram. Check out all the links to my Patreon page, Amazon links where you can help support my channel. And also, like I said, let me know your thoughts on Plex because I'm super curious. You know, I'm never saying I wouldn't do it again, but until Blu-ray ripping speeds kind of improve and you can get discs done in maybe 5 or 10 minutes and disc drives get better and computer processing gets better and bandwidth gets better for internet, I don't think it's quite there yet. I'm pretty happy with having Netflix and Hulu and Amazon Prime. If there's a movie I don't own or if I do really want to stream something on my laptop, I'll do it that way. I know that goes against what I say, but if you're in a hotel room and you don't have a Blu-ray player, I'm not going to carry around my collection with me. So I think that's a perfectly fine option if you have those and you don't necessarily need this home media server. So it is what it is. Thank you for watching. I have a really exciting collaboration coming up in my next video, so stay tuned for that one, and I'll talk to you guys very soon.